This is a really good pop-up rig. I use two pop-up rigs, the Chod rig and this one called the Multi rig. Some people call it the Johnny Mac rig as well, like because a guy called John McAllister, a really good angler, he kind of basically he's caught loads of big fish on it, but Multi rig is the correct name. And it's a rig, I think I've used it for about 8 years now, so it's not one I've used for forever, but it's really impressed me. The hook holds you get from this rig are excellent. So if you're fishing for big fish, I mean, you don't want to lose any fish, but big fish rig, this is one to definitely consider. Coated braid is absolutely perfect for this rig. And the only place that is stripped is just there below. Obviously the pop-up's going to sit like so. We'll look at it in a tank later, but where that strip there, that gives it a really good hinge. And you imagine that as the fish picks it up, that tilts down and you nail them. It's like a stiff hinged rig, like a modern version. That's how I look at it. But the clever thing with the Multi rig is your hook isn't tied on. You have a big loop at one end and the loop simply passes through the eye of the hook. You put your ring on and then the loop goes round all the way around the hook and then you pull it over. So when you hook a fish, it all pulls down tight, you know, it's solid as anything. Your knot is there. It's a double hand loop knot or a figure of eight knot. So it's a clever rig, because if your hook point bluntens, and I'm very fussy about my hook points, you can just get rid of the hook and put a fresh hook on and you're still actually fishing with the same hook link. So it's a clever rig. Good if you're fishing somewhere where bream are a problem, I use it a lot on the river because I catch a few too many chub, and chub seem to always take the point of my hook off. So I can catch a chub, unhook it, check the hook point. If it's blunt, not a problem, put a fresh one on. The hook that I use for the Multi rig is the Fang X, which is a kind of a curved style hook. And they are brilliant. One of my favourite hooks, one of the best hooks of all time. Very sharp, strong as well, and you get a really nice aggressive angle which suits this pop-up rig. Two small mouse dropping size bits of putty up the hook link just to make sure that's pinned down, and you can use any lead setup you want with this, a helicopter, a running lead or a lead clip. I use a lead clip probably 90% of the time, so it suits any lead setup, lead core, a diffusion leader, what personal choice. But let's have a look at it in the tank and we'll see how it sits. Right then, let's have a look at this little Multi rig in the water. Just drop it in carefully. There you can see, very tidy pop-up presentation. Obviously you've got kind of a D for that pop-up to sit. It will sit up the top in the water, and obviously when a fish sucks that and blows it out, it's got the movement to blow it down the shank of the hook. I like a big ring on the D's. I think I use a 2mm one, just for as much movement as I can get. The angle of the hook for me is what makes it so good. It sits perfectly. There's a little bit of silicone I use over the eye of the hook. The silicone keeps the D in position, and it also just aligns it so it comes off at that angle. Very simple to tie up this rig. It's a really good rig, but very, very simple to tie, like all the best ones. The two bits of putty up the hook link, you can see, just nail that flat to the deck. And like I say, at this end, you can have whatever lead setup, you know, of your choice. You need a buoyant pop-up for this rig, so you know, use a good quality one. This one's a nice Nash pineapple one, and it will sit up like that for 48 hours. I don't tend to leave a rig in the water that long, but you want it to be buoyant. You don't want the bait to start taking on water and move into the side, because it's not going to give you the best presentation. The stiffness of that bit under the hook, it's like a stiff hinge rig, so as the fish picks it up, it really does tilt forward, and I think it almost catches them by surprise. And like I say, the hook holds with this, usually, you know, right in the scissors, well back, hard to get the hook out, which is a sign of a rig that's working very well for you. I tend to cast it out I don't use a PVA bag with this rig because it's a pop-up, but I tend to probably use a nugget of dissolving foam around it again to get some resistance through the air and through the water, so it kicks it out straight like you can see in this tank. And it's a good rig for probably just fishing a scattering of boilies around, you know, 50 boilies, 100, 10, whatever the conditions kind of are telling you to do, but a little scattering of boilies. And I quite like a bright one over the top. Even if I'm using a monster red, I'll still fish a yellow or a white pop-up, just so it stands out a little bit of visual, and it tends to get you a few extra pickups. So yeah, excellent rig, caught me a lot of fish all times of year, from hard waters and easy waters. So very versatile, and one that's definitely worth spending a bit of time getting right.